Today we're going to be analysing both Hollywood and British independent cinema and how the two are becoming more and more similar.
Okay then, Mandy, fire away.
To compare the similarities, we're going to look at two films that came out in the same year but have very big differences in terms of cast, budget and target audience. The first film we're going to look at is the sixth instalment in the Fast and Furious franchise. The film follows the story of Vin Diesel and The Rock as they go around the globe destroying fast cars, wrestling and nearly crashing into cliffs with helicopters. The film was directed by Justin Lin and features a mammoth cast of stars including Paul Walker, Michelle Rodriguez, Ludacris, Tyrese Gibson, Jordana Brewster, Jason Statham and of course Vin Diesel and Dwayne The Rock Johnson. The film cost over $150 million to make, but has made over $780 million back, which makes it the 47th highest grossing film of all time. It was produced by Original Film and One Race Films, which is owned by Vin Diesel himself,
'cause I'll be there to kick your ass if you ain't,
and distributed by Universal Pictures. It was released in 2013, as was the other film we're going to look at, Filth.
Oh, he's one of the best, I see. That's what I see. He's one of the best.
This film, based on a novel, was directed by John S. Baird and stars James McAvoy, as well as Jamie Bell, Eddie Marson, and Jim Broadbent. The film was made on a far more modest budget of around £3 million, or roughly $5 million. Instead of sending its cast to glamorous locations around the world, Filth instead stays in a realistic depiction of Edinburgh, for the most part.
Cheers, Paul.
Cheers.
While these films may seem to be very different, it seems to us like independent films are actually beginning to have a lot more in common with Hollywood films, and the two are sometimes indistinguishable. Many Hollywood films do actually film in the UK now, but this does not make them British films. Fast and Furious 6 was actually filmed in the UK because of the law of tax relief. Films shot in the UK with a core expenditure of more than £20 million can claim a tax relief of up to 25%.
That's it?
Originally, independent films were seen as a way to launch actors and directors' careers like Tom Hardy, Kevin Smith and Jennifer Lawrence. This is especially true for James McAvoy, who appears in both Hollywood blockbusters and independent films.
Yeah, that's great, bro. Who's the man?
Now they are seen as a way for already established actors to get a chance to work in more serious films, with darker subject matters or that deal with more serious social issues and political views than a Hollywood film would. Independent films also feature a lot more mainstream music than they would have before. While they might not be orchestrated like a lot of Hollywood films are, there is still an added production cost they would not have afforded previously.
Lays me down with my mind, she runs throughout the night.
While the film Filth was produced by British production companies, including Steel Mill Picture and Altitude Film Entertainment, it was distributed by American-founded company Lionsgate.
Fuck off, Drew.
You can say it's none of my business.
None of your fucking business!
Overall, it's clear that these two seemingly very different types of films have a lot more in common behind the scenes than you would think. While it's clear these styles of filmmaking are becoming more and more similar, we do not yet know if this is a good thing or if it will lead to the independent films losing what made them unique in the first place.
You've got to be fucking joking.